Kia ora, hello. So yeah, I'll fly through a couple of slides in the next 5 to 6 minutes and then show you a little bit of a video, which is about mobile filmmaking and mobile creativity, which is really what I want to talk about today. So I myself, I'm a filmmaker, but around 6 or 7 years ago, I decided to swap my big HD cam, or my cam that I'd be using, mini DV at that time rather, with smartphones. And of course, that's sort of like, 7 years ago, that was a bit of a special thing, but I think these days, something that we all can relate to, because we all have phones in our pockets. And if you think about this in a global scale, just would like to give you this as sort of a bit of a background information. There's more than a dozen mobile film festivals, cell phone film festivals, smartphone film festivals around the world. So it's really becoming an expanding field. And of course, with sort of social media, Web 2.0 expanding, there's a number of applications that sort of link in now in all forms of the media production. So, and if you think about mobile phone filmmaking, it's a really interesting way that you can think about financing, pre-production, production, as well as post-production and distribution through various media channels. And if you just think back what happened in the last 5 years with your smartphones, I think it's going to be quite exciting to see what's coming ahead in the next 5 years. And that's sort of a bit sort of the background for MENA. And so what MENA really does is I'll give you a sort of bit of an overview of this, but I just thought I'll tell you a bit more about mobile phone filmmaking as well. So at Massey University, the Vice Chancellor, Steve Mahari, produced a TV advertisement on the smartphone because one of the Massey graduates, product design, designed that sort of iPhone. And so, or the shell for the iPhone. And so I think what is quite amazing to see is that you've got the level that smartphones can produce industry standard content. But what MENA also does is it really engages with communities. So there's two snapshots of workshops that we did in New Zealand, Aotearoa, and internationally, which is really to engage people in smartphone filmmaking. So all of us have a pocket, all of us have a smartphone in our pocket, but it might be sometimes a bit difficult to sort of, you know, get the phone out and sort of start producing work. And so that was sort of like the basic ideas when we got together, actually, right here, 3 years ago with my colleague, Laurent. And we thought, I'm a mobile phone filmmaker, and he works in transmedia. And we showcased some of our work, and we thought, wow, so that would be great, a great way to do more of this. And so MENA was found. And since then, we had 3 annual screenings and 3 symposia that explore mobile creativity and mobile innovation. And the last one was just last week, last Thursday, Friday in Auckland. But if you go to the website, mena.pro, there'll be all the information online quite soon. So at the moment, if you go to mena.pro, you can see an archive of the first 2 symposia and the showreels from the mobile films. And MENA essentially is trying to bring people together that are really interested in mobile creativity and mobile innovation. So this year we had people that deal a lot with sort of Instagram, micro-narrators. We were exploring mobile pedagogies, how mobile technologies can be used in the classroom, how they can be used to connect to communities, and things that relate to mobile phone filmmaking. And we had people, we had practitioners, we had people from the industry, and we had, like myself, practice-led researchers and researchers from the 6 leading universities. And it's also about showcasing mobile creativity and celebrating this a bit and bringing this sort of through the big screen in international respect. So what was really great to see is that in this year's showcase program, we set up some workshops, and 2 of the people that produced mobile phone films in our workshops were now shown in international cinema screening program. And as you can see, we've got quite a few partner film festivals around the world, such as the iPhone Film Festival, which is based in LA, or the Mobile Film Festival from San Diego, Cinephone from Barcelona, Extreme Short Film Festival in Korea, and even a film festival in Macedonia, which is a very interesting thing that Macedonia as a country now can develop a national cinema. And there's 2 partner festivals from Germany. And so MENA sort of is about showcasing also this mobile filmmaking sort of in New Zealand, but also showcasing the work that has been produced in New Zealand. And so through the connections, we then have a quite exciting exchange of programs and films. If I don't talk too much, I'll show you a bit of filming as well. And so it's sort of also quite nice to see that this is now being picked up in the media. And One of the things that is also quite important for MENA is to make mobile phone filmmaking really accessible to a wide range of people. So if you're interested in this, we also launched an e-book and a DVD. So every year there's a DVD that goes along, which has all the screening programs on there. So they're a great teaching tool, but they're also very inspirational. And of course, sort of thinking about mobile technologies, we also have an e-book as a distribution format. And then some of the work that we've been doing, I'm just going to wrap up in a minute now, is sort of we also developed an app for geolocative photography, which is sort of very interesting to work with communities and what some people sort of call collaboration or some people call crowdsourcing. And we produce different workshops that are sometimes online, sometimes with face-to-face interaction. And we did also some great work at the Fringe Festival with sort of public projections. So just sort of, yeah, that's MENA, but I also want to show you really some films so that you sort of get to see what I'm talking about. Just before we sort of show you the last slide with the films, so I think sociability and connectivity is really quite important for digital media and mobile technologies. So thinking about sort of the engagement of communities to make this really sustainable. Thanks.